So yesterday we discussed regarding as a GDP and a GNP. So any of the questions, queries regarding it, the GDP and the GNP of a country. GDP stands for the gross domestic product. Domestic means such number of activities which are occur within a boundaries of a country. Within a boundaries of country. And those number of activities which also included from the or earned from the abroad. Earned from the abroad, income earned from abroad plus income which generates within the economy through primary sector, through secondary sector, and through tertiary sector. Through tertiary sector. Clear? That is known as the GNP, gross national product. That is known as the gross national product. So GDP and the GNP, they indicate the growth of human resource in economy. Growth of human resource in economy. In all the economies, they emphasizing over the improvements in a human resource. Growth of human resource. Growth of human resource. Generally, we are using the two of the concepts related with the country. One as the growth, second as the development. Growth and development. Growth is the quantitative aspect which can be measured. It is a quantitative aspect. Whereas the development is a qualitative aspect. Qualitative aspects. Clear? Generally, we call as a you children, you are the grown-ups. Because your height structure, your physique has improving. Your physique, your height is improving, increasing. Why? Because it is a growth. Growth is a natural process. It is a continuous process. Growth is a continuous process, but the development, it may impact. Development, it may impact under the investment. Due to the inclusion of a more number of inputs, investment occurs, and through investment, the development can change. Sometimes the sum of the individuals, these are not as a taller, but still their height improves. Growth is a continuously occur. The physique, body weight of an individual, it has increasing. Clear? As per the normal child, some of the children are there which are not gaining the weight. Gaining weight. Clear? But in the other side, development, when we talking about the development, it can be as improve as per the conditions. If the number of the inputs we will increase in economy, number of inputs we will given to the individual, then the development will more occur. Development will more occur. For example, one example is there. When you kids entered in a pre-primary classes, your mental level. At that time, your mental level, and now after the 12 years you spend in a school education, 12 years you spent in a school education. So under these 12 years, your development, your cognitive development, mental development, it is a more comparatively the others. It will be as a vary from a person to person. Person to person. Some are there which are grasping hurriedly from their environment. In a sudden way, they grasp the things from their environment. Some are there which are slowly grasp these things. Some are the superior in a sport, some are in a studies. So it has varied from individual to individual. But development has occurred due to the number of inputs. If we give the inputs, then the more development will occur. So same as this concept has also implies on a country. Growth, number of a population. If the number of people, it will be as an increase, then the simultaneously demand will increase. For the completion of a demand, supply also affects. Supply of a goods, it has also influenced. So growth in a country, all the countries has occurred. When India and Pakistan, both they declared as an independent on a 1947. Afterwards, after the completion of 70 years of independence, India's developmental status, it improved. Now the India is a developing country. But as compared to India, Pakistan, it lagging behind. it is as an underdeveloped country. Why? Because of their policies, number of policies, number of the inputs. In our government, we are emphasizing, our government is emphasizing over improvements in health and education. The government of India, it has investing over the health, education, and training. Improvement in health facilities, cheaper health facilities provided by the government of India to their individuals. For improvements in education, it provides a number of the opportunities. Number of the facility schemes are launched by the government of India to improve level of literacy in India. Literacy in India, in which one of act as the Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan, SSA. Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan. Anybody tell me about it? The scheme, it was initiated in 2005. Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan. Anybody? What it means this? What is the target of this scheme, SSA? Except that 10% literacy or improved level of literacy in India. Except this, what is the objective set under the SSA, Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan? In the government schools, outside of the government schools, there are the, basically the pictures are showing as the what objectives are set under it. Yes, Gurupal?
Sir, SSA scheme was for to give elementary education to every child of India.
Very good. Elementary education. Very good. Any other? Gushan? Gushan Singh?
Sir, it is the primary education from the ages of 6 to 14 of fundamental rights.
Okay. Right to education. Very good. Yes, Anshya? Anshya, raise your hand. Anshya, okay. Yes, Anshya.
It made education till the years of 14 compulsory and free.
Very good. 6 to 14, as the Gushan said, and compulsory education has given in our public schools, in our governmental schools. It has targeted to increase the number of the enrollments. Earlier, what was happened? Most number of children, they left the school education before the completion of 12. So government tried to improve that number of dropouts from a school education through the different other supportive schemes. For example, as a midday meal scheme is initiated, in which as a food given to the children, for the food, some of the children, these are coming towards the schools. They are coming towards the public schools for the food because their families, they can't afford them as the two meals in a day. So this is just as the incentive given by the government to improve the number of enrollments and retention of students in a school education. Jo bachche pehle education chhod dete the because of the poor conditions to earn their livelihoods. Now that these children, they are continued their education at least till the level of a 12th standard. Till the level of 12th standard. Clear? Let's see, continue again. So for improving the health education, government of India, it invest their financial resources, their capital in a growth of a human resource. Same as I gave you the example in yesterday. In Japan, 60% of the total budget of the country, it has procured for the improvement in a health and education facilities. So that population, which is healthy, which is a professionally qualified, efficient, it can do as a work. 10% it will contribute in economy by production of goods and services. If the number of a workforce in any of a country where people are not educated, then they will dependent on other countries for the workforce. They will dependent on other countries for the workforce. So government try, all the governments, they are trying to improve the standard of health and education in their country. But in Japan, most of the money, it is spending on improving on health and education only because they are not having the other options. they can't develop the other resources. Natural resources are not found in Japan, like as agriculture and minerals. Clear? Agriculture and minerals. With improvements in a health and education, productivity per person, it can be as improved. It can increase in a productivity of a goods, productivity of human resource in country. Yes, Dhiren?
Sir, if there are no resources and no agriculture in Japan, then how do the people earn life there?
But presently, the concept of a globalization has followed by the world countries. Globalization. As I told you, they developed the, in Japan, government developed the human resource. As for the improvements in a human resource, they are basically emphasizing over the industries based upon a computer software. IT-based industries are basically localized in a Japan with support, which supply their goods towards the other countries. Their goods, which are high demanded in our present economy, these are basically exported from Japan. By the export of such goods, they complete their other needs of a survival, like food. They purchase, they imported food towards the Japan and export the IT-based goods towards the other countries of the world. Other countries of the world. Clear? Other countries of the world. There is one example as the in India, when India it declared as independent in 1947, the critical condition it was a prevail in India as the shortage of food, scarcity of food. So such deficiency of food, it can only possible to solve that problem of food through the agricultural production. Through agriculture production, they can improve the production, they can solve the problem of food in India. So for which Green Revolution, it introduced in a mid of the 1960s and the 70s. Green Revolution, in which modern techniques of farming, which includes HYV seeds, assured irrigation, fertilizers, machinery in agriculture, which improved the per hectare production. Now the India is self-sufficient in food grains with the inclusion of such modern techniques, because government it invested as per the existing requirements of a country. Government started to developments in a different sectors of economy, for which in 1950 the planning commission was set up. That planning commission first targeted towards the agriculture, then secondary sector in 1970s, 80s and 1990s. And afterwards the 1990s, government of India started to invest in a service sector. That's why the telecommunication services improved in India after 1990s. Now the Digital India in 2014, introduced by the government of India, Digital India, in which has all the different associated fields of the government, these are connected with the digital world. They are connected with the digital world. Clear? Is that clear? So there are the role of the investment in economy. The role of the investment in economy. Investment means what? Investment refers to such resources which are used to increase production or further improvements in processes associated with production. Processes associated with production means investment, means investment. It can be as a possible for a location of a newer firm. New industries can set up in through the process of an investment. Money which has invested in a field of a secondary sector for set up the newer industries. To set up the newer industries for which as a when money has procured, money has saved and used for increasing production, increase in a number of the industries for which investment can occur. Or investment, it can also occur for the processing processes. Processing of production. Processes associated with the production means improvements in techniques, improvements in machinery. Improvements in machinery. Are most number of sugar mills in India, sugar mills in Punjab, these are the outdated. Sugar mills in India are the outdated. The type of the machinery used under such sugar mills, it's a 50, 60 years old. That's why the sugar mills are known as a sick industry. Sick, it needs as the protection. And such protection, it can possible to the investment. With the investment of money in industries, we can improve the technology, techniques of our production, through which if when we improve the techniques, then the wastage will less occur and more production will raise. One example. Earlier, there was only as a one source of electricity, as a hydroelectricity, in which generation of electricity through water. But in modern in time, the non-conventional sources of energy are also one of the ways through which we can generate electricity, like solar panels, solar energy, tidal energy, wind energy, nuclear energy, geothermal energy. So all these are the ways which are the substitute of a generation of electricity as compared to hydropower. Clear? So when government has investing to improve the production or increase the production sites through the investment of our money, through the investment of capital. Yes.
Sir, please repeat the definition of investment.
Investment refers to the procurement or the use of capital for growth of new production centers or processes associated with production is a investment. Earlier, the agriculture in India, it practiced in a form of a subsistence. Subsistence means in which farmers, they produce crops for survival of their families. With commercialization of agriculture, now farmers, they are lending money from the banks and they emphasizing over such crops which are more profitable for them, means cash crops. They are generally emphasizing over the non-food crops, except wheat and rice. Now they are emphasizing over the other kinds of the crops, which are more beneficial for them. More beneficial, like sunflower, like mustard, soya bean, vegetables, fruits. They are now generally, they are emphasizing over such crops for the more profits. Earlier, the such food crops which produce in their agriculture fields through the traditional ways, at that time the production was a low graded. Production generally occur as a low graded. With investment of a government in an agriculture sector, which resulted in a form of a green revolution. Green revolution in which the genetically modified seeds, HYB seeds, use of machinery, and earlier that agriculture which was dependent on monsoons, the type of agriculture in India which earlier depended on monsoons, monsoonal rainfall, now that agriculture is possible through the assured irrigation facilities. Assured irrigation facilities with the help of canals and tube wells, farmers, they complete their necessity of irrigation and produced more and more crops. At the time of independence, that country, our country, at that time, which was as the dependent on others to complete their food requirements. Now, presently, India is self-sufficient in food grains. We are not importing the food grains. Whether we are emphasizing over the export of food grains towards other countries. Clear? So that's why the investment is more occur in our country. Investment is more occur in our country. Investment is more occurred by the government of India in our country. Clear? Presently, you are seeing that a large number of the workforce students, after completion of a plus two, they are moving towards the foreign for a better future. Why is it occur? It's due to the less number of job opportunities in India. Job opportunities, such population, it consider themselves as a burden on their families or the country. Burden on country. So liability. So to improve their capability, to utilize their efficiency, that population now it is moving towards other countries. This is also wrong. Why? Because after 10-20 years, when the 10-20-30 years it will be as a cross, then there will be as only the aged, the elders, retired persons, they will be only available in India as compared to our workforce, which now starts to move towards the other developed countries. It is as the drawback of our country. To improve the number of job opportunities, government of India opt the way of liberalization. Government of India opted the liberalization. What the liberalization means? Liberal. Government policies are the liberal. Government has relaxing the some or giving the some of the incentives to the entrepreneurs. Incentives given to the entrepreneurs through which as a services are improving in our country. A number of the services are starts to improve in our country. It which includes as the they can as borrowed the such large entrepreneurs, industrialists, they can borrow the monies from the banks. Clear? Second, as a basic infrastructure provided by the government as free of cost. Means network of roads, health institutes, educational institutes are free of cost provided by the government of India through investment. One example is there. Your parents, they are investing the resources for your better future. You are attaining the education. After completion of your plus two, you will join the professional degree colleges. And after the completion of your degrees, you will capable to contribute in economy in a form of production of goods and services. Same as government has also doing the investment. It invests their resources for the betterment of country, for the development of country. Government giving as the network of our routes, where the routes are the well developed, markets are the nearer to the located, nearness of the markets are there, well developed routes are there, sources of capital generated by the government in such areas, the entrepreneurs, they invest their resources, they invest their capital for production. What basically they started to set up their industries in such areas where the government is supportive for the growth of industries. Sometimes the government has made the restrictions. Such liberalization of India, it was opted in the 1990s. Before of it, government, it restricted the foreigners to invest money in our country. The reason was that government tried to promote the domestic producers. Jo yahan pe local producers hai, unki promotion ke liye, there were the restrictions were imposed on our foreigners. They can't set up their industrial units in India. Clear? But after the 1990s, government started to liberalize their policies. Why? Because to improve the job opportunities, other options were not there, under which as multinational companies, MNCs set up in India, IT-based industries, they started to set up in India when government of India opted liberalization. So there are two case studies are there. Story of Sakal, and story of Vilas. So these two individuals are there. The Sakal story is associated with that child which gained education and improved their standard of family. It improved the standard of their family. So that person which attaining the education and professionally qualified, it can easily attain the jobs, gain the jobs in a better sources, through the better sources. Better doesn't mean that only the government sector is there. Other private companies are also which offered the good opportunities to those which are the hard worker. In a second story, Vilas, that child, Vilas, it didn't gain the education. Because of illiteracy, it spent their life as a poorer. In the other side, as a Sakal, which generally has getting as a permanent or a regular job in a firm, in industry. In the other side, Vilas, it continued as the temporary worker, as a vendor. So when we are comparing these two conditions, Sakal and the Vilas, Sakal as the educated literate, a literate person which tried to improve their standard of their family through their capabilities. Sakal used their efficiencies to improve the standard, economic standard of their family when it gained a job in a private firm. It continued their work in a private firm. Because of this, it started to spend as the luxurious life in which as a person has attained a number of materials like as a air conditioner, refrigerators, so those which can be higher, which can occupy the such materials, so they are spending as a luxurious life. But as compared to the Sakal, Vilas spending as the poorest life, because not having as a regular source of income, and it is due to their illiteracy. Clear? Till there, any doubts? Yes.
Any doubts? Till there any doubts? Government has investing in a resources, such resources of a country, which contributes in a growth of a human resource. Human, and there are two of the ways, two services, health and education, through which a person can improve their standard of living. How? Because a person which is educated, well qualified, it can easily do as a work or contributes in economy with production of goods and services. Yes, Daljeet? Daljeet Singh?
Sir, please repeat liberalization once again.
Repeat what?
Liberalization.
Liberalization is a way, or liberalization is refers to, liberalization refers to, liberalization refers to the processes in which government supportive to improve, government support to improve economic infrastructure in country. Economic infrastructure means roads, availability of a banks which are lending money, availability of a basic services like health and education. So government has directly contributes in economy by improving the infrastructure, the basic infrastructure, economic infrastructure, which supports the entrepreneurs, industrialists to invest their resources, invest their capitals in economy. When they start to set up as a production sites, then simultaneously the jobs will improve. The number of a job opportunities, they will start to improve in a such economies where the newer firms, near industries, it will be as a setup by the government or the private entrepreneurs. If the job opportunities are there, then the brain drain will not occur. People will not move towards the other countries for the search of their livelihoods. Such workforce, which should be as a present in India for production, now it is migrate towards the other countries for the search of their livelihoods, for a better future. Yes, liberalization introduced in the 1990s in India. Liberalization introduced in India in the 1990s. At that time, Congress government was there. At that time, Dr. Manmohan Singh, it was as the finance minister. Country faced as the crisis, severe economic crisis. That economic crisis complete through the liberalization, because money which was not controlled or possessed by the government is started to the channelized to the investment. Foreigners started to invest their resources in a various fields associated with the economy. Clear? Is that clear? So this much for today.